Ma Pitoria, bo Masale, bo Maria, ba Skimile, bo Polina, bo Rorale, bo Rosina. To our channel, the Polo Twins. My name is Kinelo Polo.
My name is Keabetso Polo.
And today we are reviewing the much anticipated, the beautiful movie, a South African produced movie,
yes,
by the name of Matwetwe. So you want to watch this? It's a review, an honest review. We try not to give away too much, but to give you a taste of what a South African movie is like. We went to watch it this Saturday. Saturday was the...
No, it was on Friday.
On Friday. Out for how long?
I think for a week. It came out on the 25th. So basically, this is our first
movie review.
This is our first movie review, yeah. So we did say in one of our Get to Know Us that other segments will do movie reviews. So this is the first segment that we're doing on a movie review. And we're very happy that we're reviewing a South African movie. Basically, so yeah, we're not gonna give too much, and I think we gave people enough time to go watch it. To be quite honest, it's been a week, actually, yeah, more than a week, so it's enough time for us to actually review it. It's not like we are reviewing it under one day,
so yes. I think it's enough time. So with the movie, what you're going to expect, there's a couple of things that we are going to consider when reviewing. True. We will consider characters there,
yes.
We will consider the storyline,
yeah,
and the cinematography, yes. So, and the overall movie, how it's like,
yeah.
But trust me, we are not hoping to give you everything about the movie and you end up not going to watch. Please go out to cinemas. We went to watch it at the Stekinoko in Rosebank, the zone, so hopefully it's there at your nearest Stekinoko.
Actually, guys, I think it's very important that we do support local films, because we know that they don't make money, and the less screening that they have, the less money that they're going to make. Yes, we understand movies are very expensive. We did pay a lot of money to go watch it, but it's not every day that we get a South African movie. As much as we make hype of other movies, I think we can make hype of this movie. And so the movie, as we most of us know it, it was produced by Black Coffee and
Kagiso Lediga, who is essentially a writer of the movie. He did almost everything,
yeah, and we know him from comedy, because yes, he's a comedian. And also Tamsin Anderson, he's I don't know if it's a he or she, I'm sorry, but I don't know the person, but kudos to you, because you gave us a very beautiful movie. So in a space of 3 days, I think 3 days or a week, it made about 900k on the screens, which is very good
for a South African, yay,
which is very good. We're very happy about that. So they added more cinemas, so you guys can go out there and do things. You don't have an excuse. You don't have, yeah. So without any further ado, I think we should get into it, and we should, Kinelo must just tell us what she thinks,
okay,
about the movie.
Okay, so the background of the movie, just so you know, Matwetwe.
No, wait, you know what? I think before you can tell us about the background, you need to tell us what did you think the movie was about before we can tell you guys what the producers are telling us.
Okay, let me get this one out of the way.
Hmm.
Firstly, watching South African movies, normally before I go to a cinema, I watch the
trailers
of the movies, right? And I've watched so many South African movies at the cinemas. I normally don't even download South African movies, because most of the time you can't find them. So I go all the way to the cinema, and even if it's not a South African movie, I go to the cinema often, but I try to watch trailers before going, before choosing a movie, and based on the trailer I will decide whether I'm watching this movie or not.
Mm.
One thing I've noticed with our South African produced movies, the trailers, like,
they don't know how to choose the parts.
No, they don't know. And the only reason I go and watch it, even though the trailer is like meh, is because it's a South African movie. Normally, if it's not a South African movie and I watch a trailer and I don't like what's on the trailer, I choose a different movie. But with this one, I didn't like the trailer, and I wasn't sure. I was just like, no, I wouldn't want to watch this from the trailer. But what you thought about the trailer?
No, I'm sorry, I have to disagree with her. Let me tell you one thing. I know I spoke of marketing, right? So this movie was marketed on TV, on our local television, SABCs and all those things. So I said to my little sister, because of the trailer, I said to her, we need to go watch this movie. I don't know if it's because of the soundtrack, because yay! Yay, I can tell
they've
you
got,
that.
Yeah, they've got very nice sound.
I was quite impressed. Quite honestly, I was impressed. I'm
from
sorry.
The trailer.
Yes, that's exactly the reason why I said we must go watch the movie. Yes, there's so many things. They didn't even quite like capture, but from the trailers that I watched on SABCs and all these.
Okay, I haven't seen the trailers on TV, I will be honest, because I don't watch much of a TV. I only saw the trailer. If it's the same one that's on TV with the one that's on the website, I wasn't sold. I don't know the trailer that's on TV, but what I watched on the Stay Kinoko website and the trailer, I was just like, why do you want us to go watch this? But I watched it because it's South African. That's it about the trailer. About the movie, when I saw Matoetoe, I was like, okay, I wasn't sure what to expect. Let me be honest, I wasn't sure what to expect. The trailer would give you a bit of what Matoetoe is about, but even then I wasn't sure what to expect. And
for me, the trailer also didn't give much, like I'm saying, but it was quite interesting. It was catchy. I didn't know what Matoetoe means, quite honestly, and I kept on wondering, what is Matoetoe? What do they mean? For me, let me tell you, I personally thought, when I watched the movie, when I got out of the cinema, for me, the movie, if I can tell you this much, it's about the life in our hood, like the life kokasi, basically, in townships, how we live, our everyday lives. It's basically that two guys hustling to make it out of the hood. That's how I found
so
it.
Yeah, it's so relatable. I think music, you relate very well because it's South African music that we love. I mean,
you obviously knew it from there
and you wanna watch this, right?
Exactly.
And there's also Bukulichana.
I mean, it's a homeboy, honestly.
Black coffee. So the music, whoever A1. Chose the music, guys,
A1,
it's on point. Thank you for choosing the music.
You.
We loved the music. That's a yes from me.
A very high yes. And you know what I love about South African movies, right? So everything is so relatable, especially when they take things exactly from Kasi. Same as Jerusalem, same as Tsotsi, like those kind of movies that touches you so that you know very well. Uguti,
this
I'm sorry,
happened.
But there's crime where we come from, guys. I know those things, we must tell them. Yes, boom, what is a four-letter word? They're romance and nice, and they try a bit to be American, but they're also nice. I'm not saying anything bad about them. But those ones, I think maybe it's because I love Spitori and those people from Mabopane, Harangua, Batubako Peli, and Big. It's just so catchy.
Yeah,
it's
so I think
beautiful.
We're going on without telling people the background. So the movie is about two guys selling, I don't know what you guys call it. We call it Motekwane in our language. So they go around. One of the two guys is trying to make money so that he can go to varsity. There's different storylines, but it's mostly based on those two guys sailing. It runs, you will see after that it actually runs for one day. It's a movie. It's just one day.
Yeah.
The 31st of December.
I
wanted to tell you, like, guys, did you see? When we got out of the cinema, I'm like, did you see? But this thing is on the 31st of December. Yes, so they're just trying to make a living. One of the guys is from a rich family. The other one is not from a rich family and trying to make money to go because he's accepted at one of the universities in South Africa. There's other things like showing the crimes where a guy beat up his wife to a point where the wife died. There's other stories about one of the guys that's actually something very terrible happened and he lost his girlfriend now. there's not okay in the head, but it's all those nice things that make you feel like okokasi and you can relate, and you know, you can even point out this character ke mamang back home, this character ke mamang back home, because it's that relatable. So that's exactly what the movie is about. And like we said, so my daughter, for me, music hands up. For you,
music a very high hands up.
And now characters get to it.
Do you think anybody killed it?
The characters, I love that they chose, they opened the industry. Remember, recently there's been also talks about opening up the industry. True. Like it's been in the past. So they literally opened the industry. The faces there, I knew only one person. And you'll have to see for yourself, unless you know people, those characters from somewhere. But it's people that I am not familiar with, that I've never seen, but they did very well according to me. It's only one person that I knew. Other than that, the characters for you?
I think for me, I have a favorite. I'm sorry. The characters, they were A1, obviously. And as we're talking about opening the industry, I like that about South African movies. They always go, especially those ones that touches our souls, they always go for people that we don't know, which is very good. They unleash new talent.
Yes.
So there are two guys, mainly. It's Papi and Lefa.
Mm.
So I can't remember which one is Papi and Lefa, but there's one with albinism. That one, the best for me. He killed his part. I was like, you know what? Yes, the other one, he's also good. Everybody was good. But you know, there's always that person. It's like the character was made for them. They have that thing, guys. I loved him. So character-wise, I think...
You give it to...
I would give it, out of 10 character-wise, I would give it 8.5. 8.5.
For me, there's no one that really killed that characters. They were all good. I don't think anyone stood out for me, but I think they are very good actors and actresses.
Mm.
So I would give it a 7 from the characters. Very well played. I loved it. Yes, they could have put in more effort in the character, but I mean, they've done well. I loved the characters.
Yeah.
And the storyline, for me, the storyline was very good. I love the storyline, the flow of the storyline. So I would say you wouldn't be confused. It's an easy to follow storyline, very relatable storyline, something that you could actually like identify with. So the storyline was, for me, good. I would definitely say go out there and watch it.
I agree with her. The storyline for me, it was perfect. I followed everything. I did say to her, when we walked out of the movies, we saw these other white people. So I said to Genelo, because the movie is basically in Venek, did we love it? For us, are we already loving it because of Spidori?
We are biased.
And I wanted to get their
opinion on,
because I would suppose that they don't know some. I know some white people, they do know Tswana, Soto, and all these other languages. So I wanted to know, for them, did they catch the storyline?
Did they relate as much as we did? Because I mean, there are subtitles. I don't know how you guys feel about subtitles, but because Ronamoto, you understand Tswana, you understand Spitori. I mean, guys, Spitori is a language on its own. It should be the 12th official language. So you don't look at the subtitle. So for some people that do not understand, they would have to rely on subtitles, and obviously you lose the meaning, you lose the flavor in it. I mean, kaubuza jo in English, but like, wala koi, I'm telling you.
But you gotta get it. But also, we watching Siebe Dilan, and we grew up watching Siebe Dilan, so we also relied on
the subtitles. So maybe, yeah.
Yeah, so I think, but besides that, obviously there are other few white people in the movie, but A1, I'm not gonna lie to you, relatable, very well played storyline. It was, you can follow it very easily. And I love that the movie wasn't long. That's what I love the most.
Guys, it doesn't matter how nice a movie is for me. If it goes over 2 hours, I'm sorry. Like
over 1 hour 30 minutes, it's just like...
Actually, but that one is not too long, so it's very nice. But the other thing that I thought was unnecessary about the movie is the narration.
I'm against her on that one. I thought it was nice.
I will tell you why.
Why?
Firstly, I'm not sure why they had those two guys and one lady narrating, because I could have easily followed what was happening on the movie without their narration. Secondly, I thought they were meant to be funny. I'm sorry, I'm a very hard person to please when it comes to comedy and whatever. I really do not laugh at anything and everything. So they were not funny, according to me.
For me, I think the narration, it's not like it was necessary, but it did the part. It worked. So for me, it's fine. I was just worried when it started. I was like, I hope we're not going to watch something where there's like 2 minutes of a movie and narration, 2 minutes of a movie and narration. But only to find that it wasn't like that. So for me, they played that part.
Kudos for the
storyline.
I give the storyline 8.5.
I also give it 8.5.
So it was very good cinematography. It was shot at, you can see Jorge, it's a location shoot. Give it an 8.
Okay. For me, I also loved it because of location, and also, like, you know, sometimes we watch movies and it's like they used our camera, like, you know, so they use proper camera, and everything was the way it's supposed to be.
Not too much editing.
Yes, not too much editing, and they didn't try too hard. So you know what, everything was flowing. It was like you in the movie. You can see yourself somewhere there with Barbie and Lefa. You understand what I'm saying? So it was then. So we loved it. I loved it.
Yes.
So I will also give it an 8. I know, guys, I'm giving it 8, 8, 8. But you know what? It was that good.
So I would say for me, go out, watch the movie. It's a beautiful movie. Mm-hmm. South African produced. Kagiso Lediga did a brilliant job on this movie.
A1.
You will definitely love it. All the other producers, you guys did fantastic. I loved every part of the movie. Mm-hmm. I will say, and I keep saying, we just had a friend over since we watched the movie. We told her to go watch the movie. Mm-hmm. So go out, watch the movie, support local. And this one, you will realize you are not only supporting local because it's local, you are supporting a good movie. You will definitely love it.
I'm also echoing exactly what she's saying, guys, that the movie was very beautiful. We are not getting paid to say that the movie is A1, and we loved everything about it, even though the ending was like shaky, but everything about it, it's very nice. So go out there, make your own review about it, comment on the thingy,
comment
down
link below,
tell us what you thought of the movie.
Who was your best character? What didn't you like about it? What do you think can be done better? But for me, definitely, obviously, we don't have much money for marketing, but I say, guys, do better with your
marketing,
not only marketing, man. Those clips before the movie
on trailers,
do better with the trailers. I said if it wasn't South African, from the trailer I would have missed out because I wouldn't have gone and watched the movie.
Mm-hmm.
But do better with the trailers. But the movie, kudos. I give the movie actually 9/10.
That's a very good one. I also give it 9/10, not because it's South African,
overall,
but because it deserves it, of the quality, of the character, of the storyline. The music, guys!
Actually, did I tell you how much I give the music? 10/10?
Yeah, the music is the 11/10. Listen, the music is A1.
Like,
we cannot fault it.
Guys, you will love it. So go out there, watch it, and enjoy the movie.
Yay! Guys, comment down below, like this video, and also share it with your friends, with your relatives, everybody. Tell us on the comment section what you thought of the movie and who was your favorite character.
Subscribe. Till next time, the Pulu Twins, thank you for watching.
Thank you, guys. And also for the people that subscribe, we appreciate it.
We really appreciate it. And for taking the time to watch, you guys are awesome. Till next time, bye-bye.